ChatGPT is becoming a super powerful everyday assistant. Deep research, projects, canvas, custom GPT, tasks, the list goes on. And as digital marketers, we are all excited about these features. But honestly, features are useless if they're not integrated into your workflows and solving real problems. So in this video, I'm showing you how to connect them all together into one single powerful workflow that turns ChatGPT into your super digital marketing teammate. So you can get more of your time back, and these workflows can be applied to any kinds of brands. Let's go. Our workflow starts with where all great strategy begins, market intelligence. But we are not just going to run another one of the research tasks. Instead, this research becomes the brain of our AI digital marketing team that we are going to build. Everything we create from here, we automatically reference it. So everything stays perfectly organized and on brand. Let me show you. Let's say I'm the digital marketing team for this brand, EcoNext. And here is the brand overview document with the basic information like product offerings and target audience. But instead of simply upload these to the chat window, we will first set up a project on ChatGPT called the marketing team. If you don't know what is a ChatGPT project, so it's just like a dedicated workspace that keeps your chats organized, and you can attach specific project files and custom instructions and be able to select different GPT models. This project will work like the central hub for all the ongoing digital marketing tasks, strategy brainstorming, content generation. So now upload the brand overview file and then set up the custom instruction, asking it to be the marketing team lead and to always structure outputs for clarity with use of bullet points. Now we are ready to run the deep research, and this is what makes the project so useful, as you can still access all the tools like image generation models, web search, and now even deep research within a project. So initiate deep research with this prompt to research our target audience, like their digital behavior, channel preference, key pain points, desire, content gaps, and purchase decision factors, etc. So these will help us to formulate our digital marketing strategy. So you can see we're not just simply triggering a normal deep research, but with all the context about the brand info we provided in the project. It has finally gathered 24 sources, and the report is super detailed and comprehensive, with the details about our primary and secondary target segments, the digital behavior, channel preference like Instagram, YouTube, Pinterest, and you can always click the source for verification, and the pinpoint details, content formats, and some of the exact quotes or language used by the audience. Also with the emerging trends, competitive content gaps and opportunities, decision factors. So this is a great start for working on our strategy. So export the report, as we're about to fit it right back into our AI marketing team. Deep research is just data until you turn it into winning strategy. Now that ChatGPT has done the heavy lifting on research, and so we're about to transform this data into a comprehensive digital marketing strategy, persona analysis document, and a unique brand voice that will guide every piece of content that we create. Don't underestimate this step, as this will build a really strong foundation for your marketing engine. Now we're gonna upload back the deep research report to this project we just did, and then we'll first generate a detailed persona documents. So switch to the reasoning models O3 for the best possible results. Ask ChatGPT to base on a deep research and build 3 customer personas with the demographic details, pain points, content preference, purchase journey. So it has come up with 3 personas, and I like it because these personas are all with good purchasing power. And it also includes their values and lifestyle, digital behavior. So this is incredible. Now we will take a step further based on the 3 customer personas and generate the digital marketing strategy document that aligns with our goals, and so everything will be tied together perfectly. And this time, turn on Canvas mode to make sure it will get triggered. So Canvas is just like a collaborative interface where you can make edits or changes to the document, and similar to how you work on a Google Doc. And I like how they state our business objective and highlights the brand positioning as reference back from the project file. And then with all the details we need for the digital marketing strategy, like what are the channels we should prioritize, how to differentiate in our messaging. So this is perfect. And then click here to download as a PDF file. The last step is to also generate the brand voice and channel guidelines as well. So ask it to prepare this brand voice guideline with the channel specific adaptations, tone variations, messaging hierarchy, and immediately it will pull the guidelines with everything we need. And especially I like this messaging hierarchy, how we should frame it for different personas, and the do's and don'ts with examples. So now our digital marketing team has these guidelines to be used. And of course, you can always adjust it before you finalize. And here is the most exciting part. As we're going to use this strategy, documents for any kinds of multi-channel campaign with content access that are perfectly targeted and on brand. And the great news is once you establish this workflow, you can literally use it again and again for whatever marketing campaign, launches, or projects that you're doing. Now in the same marketing team project, upload all the files we generated in the previous step. The customer persona details, digital marketing strategy plan, and the brand voice guideline. And so you can immediately turn ChatGPT into a marketing teammate with all the background knowledge and ready to work for you. So for example, we are planning a back to school campaign and we are going to work the campaign assets using ChatGPT. So our first campaign assets is a 1000 word hero blog post with the target keyword plastic free lunch containers, targeting our primary persona, and this time switch to GPT 4.5 as it's better for creative writing. And the best thing is that you don't need to restate any of the tone of voice guidelines, and it will immediately referencing all the project files we upload. And I like how the content speak conversationally and directly to our target persona, who is a millennial mom, rather than being formal, and is referencing our brand voice as well. You can definitely tell 4.5 model is much better than 4.0 model in writing. It's more natural without sounding like a sales pitch. And with Canvas mode, you can always make changes or directly ask ChatGPT for added suggestions, which I found is a useful feature. And it will immediately highlight where you can enhance it, like this one. So just click apply and it's done automatically. And you can also click here to view the previous version to keep track all the changes made. And everything can be changed in Canvas, like formatting, content length. And once done, we can export it to a Word document. And this is not just a piece of content generation. It's targeted for our customer persona, messaging, and using our brand tone of voice. And now we can even generate some visual assets. So switch back to 4.0 model for image generation. And one great thing about ChatGPT is you can connect to your Google Drive to retrieve any extra context. Perhaps in this case is our visual style references. So I can pull back all the sample visuals that I think align with the brand and then use this prompt to ask it to generate the hero image for the blog post. And note, I suggest using the keyword horizontal aspect ratio as I found using 16 to 9 might not work. And I love this hero image, it's bright, fit for our target persona, and matches the actual blog content. And then we can even ask it to generate two more mood shots to be used in this article to make it even more engaging. So this time specify to be square aspect ratio, and I love this style and overall tone. So it feels fresh with a good eco-friendly positioning for the brand identity. The only complaint I have is it didn't follow the instructions to generate two moonshot images. So let's do it one more time. And I like this image, it looks realistic and matches all the visual tone for the other two. But I always recommend only using AI-generated humans in casual mood shots, but not overly use it, especially where human connections matters for your brand. So immediately we have our first set ready to use assets that are tied with our brand messaging, and the blog is ready to post on whatever platform that you're using. And now we can use the same way to generate all the campaign assets or content. For example, Pinterest poses with visuals, titles, and description. And these will all stay on brand and ready to use with minimal adjustment needed. As well as other channels like Instagram carousel post copy, we can just ask ChatGPT to generate 6 carousel post ideas for the campaign that stick with our messaging. And I can see it's following the example reference and the guidelines. So this is a great starting point. And more than that, we can also to generate email copy, design email sequence for a campaign with different subject lines options and CTA that link back to our product page, and so much more other types of content like Google Ads, YouTube script, TikTok script. So imagine whatever campaign that you're planning, this method will be much more efficient to make sure everything is aligned without you going back and forth. So that's why the research and strategy planning process in the first place is so important to make sure everything can be scaled. Now, what if you're working with your actual marketing team and need to scale not just at individual level, but also at a team level? A ChatGPT project is powerful, but it cannot be shared. So I'm gonna show you the solution. That is using a custom GPT. What makes a custom GPT truly different from a ChatGPT project is that it can be shared with others through a link, while a project for now is only at an individual level usage. So think of it like a specialized assistant and do certain specific tasks over and over again. And in this case, we can create a content creation assistant for this brand so each of our marketing teammates can use it. So just go to GPT and click create. So here you can configure all the details for your GPT, like name, description, instructions, like its role, the content creation approach, any platform specific requirements, or anything that you think is important. And then the starter question. And here, the most important part is the knowledge files. So here we will upload all the generated strategies, style, and guidelines, and all visual style references here, just like what we did in the ChatGPT project. So once you click create, you can immediately share this GPT with your teammates to use it. And now whenever your team needs to generate content for the brand, they can just insert the prompts and be able to achieve the same on-brand assets results as in a ChatGPT project. And we use it again and again for whatever content needs. For example, a blog post with canvas mode, blog images, and you can always fine-tune your GPTs to adjust how the content should be generated. So this is an incredible way ChatGPT will take your digital marketing process a step further. So perhaps you have your content calendar planned, and you can just attach this plan to your marketing team project or to this team GPT and ask it to execute and generate the content that will always be on brand and have your persona in mind. Now we can make this workflow even more efficient. That is setting up and automation with tasks and let ChatGPT handle all the busy routine tasks for you. First, we need to switch to our reasoning models. The reason for this is that I realize nowadays you can only create tasks using reasoning models like O3 or O4 Mini. I'm not sure why, but perhaps OpenAI just changed it. And in this case, I would just pick O4 Mini. Now in the same marketing team project, ask it to create tasks. So every Wednesday morning, it will scan for all the trending sustainability topics, including popular Reddit communities, recent eco-related news for topic inspiration. But we are not just simply asking for content ideas. We will make sure ChatGPT includes how these topics relate to our personas, and also to draft a complete, ready-to-publish social media post that aligns with our content pillars and brand voice guidelines. So when you see this little box, that means a task has been successfully scheduled. And you can click here to edit or refine the task details or adjust the schedule time. Or you can click to view all the tasks that you created. And you can always go to the settings, notification, and select how you would like to be notified when a task is completed. So I would just keep the default setting to web push or email. So every time when this marketing task is done, you will receive a notification, and you will see the proposed topic like this one, the plastic-free July, with the full post copy, hashtags, rationale about how it related to our customer personas. And this thread will be kept within the same marketing team project, so you can always reference back and keep it organized. So you can see just these small actions will immediately improve your digital marketing workflow efficiency. And not just drafting copies, perhaps tracking your competitors' messaging, draft email copy, blog posts, marketing meeting summaries, and it will always tie back to your marketing strategy and provide meaningful outputs to you. If you really want to master ChatGPT and maximize the results you get from it, my best recommendations for you is think and system. Not features, not tasks, always think of it like building blocks. Research connects to strategy, strategy connects to content, content connects to automation. Each piece makes the other stronger and to solve a real problems together with your own judgment. Join my community if you want to learn how to be more thoughtful of using AI in digital marketing. You will get access to all my actual prompts I use in all my channel videos, our regular live sessions, and all the extra content. You can find the link in the description to join. And before you go, check out this video about ChatGPT deep research if you're a big fan of it. I'll see you next time.